Short one.
I would ask him, will you take it easy when it is your turn? Then he would say no. Then be like me.
That's true. Your work requires a lot of
correct.
Time and courage and energy. I wanted to ask you, you have been married for 17 long years. How hard was it for you to manage your personal life and your profession?
See, I am the blessed one because my family really supported me. It was hard for me because I used to miss them. But it was never hard for me because I'm working. It was hard for me because I had to give more time for my work and my challenges outside than my house front. And I'm actually a homebody. I love being home, and I never thought I'll be so much out, as a professional when I'm working. So it took a toll on me as an emotion, like mother and wife and. So, but I had to manage, and my family really supported me. My husband and my son, they were really considerate, and they took care of all the other stuff, and whatever time we spent always proved to be very quality time.
That's what an inspiration. I now open the
floor for Vidya. Ma'am, how does it feel being on the cover of Savvy?
Actually, it feels very proud. And it feels little different also because I saw all the Savvy cover pages. I am the only one little odd here because everybody is so glamorous and everybody is in acting field. And they whatever I saw, and it made me feel. See, I have done many interviews. I have come on the media and magazines or. In the newspapers, but this made me feel very proud of being a woman. Savvy made me feel like a proud woman, actually. And Andrea, the credit goes to both of them, sir, but she was so nice, and the interview went on so well, and she's an amazing person.
We have seen a lot of crisis circumstances in your family. So what prompted you to come into public life, and how these tragedies have changed you as a person?
See, I was in public life, before my dad died, I was working with him for 5 years. After that, I lost him. So those 5 years, then I worked with him as a colleague, as a junior, as a daughter. I learned a lot. And somehow, that prepared me for whatever was coming. If I would have come directly after his death, or it would have been totally different scenario. But tragedies do change you internally. Externally, in professions like ours, we cannot show every time. But it does change you internally. It made me more serious and more responsible towards everything around me. My people who believe in me and my dad, my family, my extended family. I want to secure everyone. So I have become more like a father figure in the family. So it has changed me and made me more seriously responsible person.
Are you happy with the portfolio that has been granted? And what schemes are you planning to do in the portfolio?
I'm very happy with the portfolios I was granted and now I have. I had 4 ministries and I have given very successful and famous schemes in every department. Jalil Chivar was done by me. Then now I'm doing sanitary napkins, Asmita scheme, where even Akshay Kumar joined us and he adopted 10,000 girls, and government is doing for all the school girls. Also, I have done for female feticide to control that and have more girl child. So I've done those schemes. I have done rural roads. It's a huge scheme, 30,000 kilometer I'm building by 2019 December. So all these schemes are doing very well, and I'm very proud of that because I could work in the rural area and I could see real state where people are really deprived of so many things, and I could help through my ministry.
Admirable how you took charge of the entire situation on your home ground and also the party. What is that one quality in you where you sailed through this crisis scenario and emerged as a winner?
I think it's not my quality directly, but I feel honestly people's belief in me makes me very strong. So I think it's trust which people have in me, and maybe I could develop that bond with them. So that is very important more than anything. Sometimes you are emotionally really attached with someone, but you don't trust that person. But sometimes you trust that someone who you respect a lot. So I think I want to also, and I have also gained that trust from people, and they could believe in me. And that's why I'm here.
Hi, ma'am. Could you say your life has changed after marriage, and what advice would you like to give?
My life has changed after marriage, but for good. Not for bad, because I was in a very conservative family. So my husband showed me the world. He showed me how nightlife of Mumbai, and he showed me the world. He loves to travel. So I am married to a more modern man than my father. My father was very modern in thinking, but he was as well as conservative and more socially inclined. And my husband is very chilled out and very happy person. So it has changed me. For me, it has changed for good. So it has not. I have not lost anything after marriage. Rather, I gained. I'm happy. I'm touched. I'm lucky. So I would advise everyone to take it positively. But not everyone is lucky. So sometimes even men complain their life has changed after marriage. So it is all. Same on all the sides. I'll just turn this side, because they will see.
Yeah, ma'am. Adding on to her question, I would like to know, like, what kind of response or what kind of support you got it from your in-laws, and how much important is it for a woman to have such kind of support for growing and exploring the opportunity?
See, my in-laws are the least interfering in-laws. We don't stay in same house. We stay in Mumbai. My in-laws are in Pune. Before we were in US, even in Pune we stayed in separate houses because they believed in having our giving us our own freedom, and it was so mutually done. It was not like we fought or something. We always, when I was shifting from their house to my house, I was feeling so heavy and so sad. I said, please come with me, why don't you come with me? It was that kind of a relation. But they never interfered with my life, or they never asked me for anything, and I never waited for them to ask me. I also pampered them as much as I could pamper my own family. I really loved them and pampered them. And we don't interfere with each other and make them, एक दूसरे के हर चीज़ में टांग अड़ाना वगैरह हमारे फैमिली में बिल्कुल नहीं. एवरीबडी इज इंडिपेंडेंटली प्लेस्ड एंड एवरीबडी इज, बट दैट इज नॉट द सिनेरियो एवरीवेयर. सो आई एम ब्लेस्ड. मे बी आई वॉज गोइंग टू गेट सो मच ऑफ पेन एंड स्ट्रगल इन फ्यूचर, सो गॉड गेव मी दैट मच ऑफ स्पेस वेर आई कुड बी लिटल ईजी. सो दैट इज या many actually my marriage when my proposal came for my marriage I asked him ke mama aisa, this is the thing, so he said go ahead. So I trusted his decisions and also I trusted my father, but my father always looked at him as an elderly person and he always, whatever family matters, he used to always discuss with my mama and he used to always participate in our decisions and always suggest us. So we always had a very strong bond and I loved him and liked him and he was great, there's no doubt. But he also mutually had that thing for me especially. We shared that bond. And when I made my software, I used to run a little software company. So that was inaugurated by him when he was IT minister. And I gave my first speech in English in front of him. Then my feet were, my legs were shaking, but my voice was very calm. So he said, see this quality. So she said, Gopinath, she will go very far. So he always believed in that. So I think we shared that bond. And when my wedding also, he was there throughout. And in Marathi, we give that ukhana, anyone is Maharashtrian here. So we have to take your husband's name in a poetic manner. So I didn't know anything. I kept on calling him by name. So my mama made it instantly because he was very quick with his words and very smart. So he made a ukhana for me, a poetic thing, and he whispered in my ears and I told him. So that is a thing. When you eat something, he had loved eating from our plate. So whenever we are eating in front of TV, he'll come and take a bite. He loved that. So he used to love eating. He loved food.
Ma'am, what is your opinion about Narendra Modi?
I'm too small to give opinion about him. I'm working under his leadership and his inspiration. Yes? Is it matching with me what I am? I tried very hard. Because I didn't want to look like who's very Pankaja.
In fact, you have to tell us a secret behind your gorgeous hair and
genetic, all genetic. Is with me, everything is genetic. My leadership, my oratory, my hair, and my height, weight, everything is comes from my father. He had thick hair, and we all have good hair in our family. Touch wood, we all are very good hair. Top is very covered. So, otherwise, gorgeous or just. Little high word.
Pankaja, not much is known about your husband. Can you tell us a little about how the two of you met?
Oh, it's an arranged marriage, totally. But it looks like a love marriage because we bonded so well, we gelled so well, and he gave me that friend. I never had a friend who was a boy because we had a group of 10 people where 4 boys, 5 girls. We had a big group in Ruya College. But I was not very close to some friend. So he had that. After marriage, he became my boyfriend actually. So we got married in a situation where we didn't know each other so well. So then it was more fun actually exploring each other. So he's a very happy and very easy person. Very hot tempered though. But he's changed now with age.
Last two questions.
No, no, no. I will take their question also later because they are both in long time. Unam and me are very good friends. We have been brought up together. After me, she was born, so I was very attached to her. She's my first sibling. after her, my real sisters are born. So my real two sisters and me and Poonam, four, were like real sisters. Like, we were very thick. And we have grown up together. We have shared our happiness, sorrows, everything. So we don't have any rivalry. And we don't share space, same space in politics to have rivalry. She's, you know, central politics. She's totally different area she's working in. I'm totally working on a different scenario. So hopefully we don't have rivalry. People do expect that there should be something. But we don't have that kind of a problem yet. And we don't want to have it in future. We really love each other. And we always, we are, both of us are fighters. So we are standing here because of a lot of good deeds of our parents also. So we want to respect that.
Thank you.
Aap kya piche?
Ma'am, actually, can you tell us about the bond that you share with your siblings? And like, what kind of role you play in their life, in the LS system?
See, my younger sister is 4 years younger than me. She's a doctor and now she's a member of parliament. And the youngest one is a lawyer. She just came from Cornell. She finished her master's there. I'm very proud of the youngest one, because after dad, she had promised dad that she'd go abroad and take her degree. And on her merit, she's gone and in Ivy League. Saath pushto bhi koi Ivy League college mein nahi gaya. She's very brilliant, very clear about her thoughts. I'm very proud of her. Though she's 12 years younger to me, she sometimes acts she's older than me, because she can dictate me only in this world. And the young Pritam, the middle one, is very subtle, very shant and typical doctor type. She doesn't have much to say, but she's also very strong. She doesn't say much, but does she? Whatever she wants to do, she does. So we all get along very well. And now after that, they don't take me as a sister. They really take me as a head of the family. And they do listen to whatever I say. Final decision is mine. And still today, they have maintained that. Last is yours. Poor thing, long time she's doing this. Last.
Being a politician, state, it is assumed that you get special treatment in school and colleges. So what was your experience like that?
Sometimes you get specially bad treatment also. It's my experience. Because when you're somebody in our society, people try to judge you more than ever. So they say, "Acha, ye padhai mein to achhi nahi hogi. She must be very rude, she must be very proud of herself, she must be very snobbish." They assume things about you. So I suffered that, literally, not as... There were many problems than advantages, actually. So, because I studied in ZP school in the beginning. My father believed that we should have grounds, you know, that clear, we should have our foot on ground. So we studied in ZP. Then I came to Jai Hind, then came to Ruya. So Jai Hind I did not do much, because it was my first year in Mumbai and I was very lost. But Ruya I enjoyed, and nobody would ever said in my school, from my KG till my graduation, that okay, she's somebody's daughter and she threw you know, attitude at us. Never. I got along with my professors, my teachers, my friends. I was also in my politics in my school, college days. I was joint secretary of the college, so I got along with everyone. I always was crowded then also by people around me. But I was very timid. I used to not be very outgoing person that time. You can ask as many as possible. I have 5 more minutes.
I want to ask you a special question.
Oh.
In your area, Pali, Bid, Ambazogai, Aljit, whatever, Latur. So there are a lot of water problems.
Yeah.
So you have to say something about water problems, because today is International Water Day.
Yeah, I know. I tweeted about that in the morning. I have to say about water every day, actually, because I am from a drought-prone area, and I really suffered as a politician or as a social worker there, when I saw people going for miles for one pot of water, which we call ghagar. So I used to, when I used to give speeches also, I used to see little girls with their little lotas on the head and used to walk behind their mother, thoda pani leke. So I used to always wonder, what should I do for them? And I decided then, if I come with power, I will change this and I will make sure that something regarding water conservation is done. So that's why Jalyug Shivar came in picture. I was working on that before also. When I was not in power, I used to work on minor irrigation a lot with NGOs. So now the scenario has changed. But sometimes geographically you are placed in an area where you can't do much. But we have to preserve water there and conserve. So we are doing a lot of effort and it is going successfully.
And they say that politics is a man's world. So how difficult is it for you to do your work in such a...
See, they feel it is their world, so they feel more insecure than me.
If you are not in politics, if you were not in politics,
yeah,
then what would have been done?
I would be doing something very creative. I would be a writer. I would be writing good scripts and making good movies. That was my dream. So I would be, one day I'll be writer. Definitely.
Thank you so much, Tejana.
I've never heard in any question.
Thank you so much. Remove.
One second. Team
Savvy
come.
Global Advertiser for innovative outdoor solutions.
Global as a company, it has never compromised on its service, quality and commitment. And that is the reason our clients do keep on coming again and again to us for our service. The mission of the company is to rise on the graph of betterment for every campaign handled by us.
Sir, aapki film The Great Leader aa rahi hai. इस पर कुछ रोशनी डालिए।
रोशनी लीडर के साथ अपने आप चलती है और हम क्या रोशनी डालेंगे उसके ऊपर। एक बहुत ही अच्छा विषय है इस फिल्म का, महिलाओं के प्रति जो है समाज में आजकल और कई गांवों में कई क्षेत्रों में अत्याचार होता है, उनको बढ़ावा नहीं दिया जाता। इसी के दायरे में ये कहानी बनी गई है। हीरो के पिता की भूमिका हम निभा रहे हैं और हमारी पत्नी जया जो है वो हमारी पत्नी का रोल कर रहे हैं। तो ये एक हिंदी वर्जन है, तो मुझे बड़ा गर्व है कि मैं इस फिल्म में काम कर रहा हूँ।
द ग्रेट लीडर फिल्म के निर्माता दीपक सावंत हैं, जो पिछले 45 वर्षों से आपके मेकअप आर्टिस्ट हैं। लोग जानना चाहते हैं कि शूटिंग पर दीपक सावंत आपकी नज़र में मेकअप आर्टिस्ट होते हैं या निर्माता?
ये मेकअप आर्टिस्ट पहले मेकअप हमारा करते हैं, उसके बाद ये निर्देशक बन जाते हैं।
इस फिल्म की सफलता के लिए आप दर्शकों से क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
ग्रेट लीडर जो है वो जा करके देखें और मैं उम्मीद करता हूं कि आपको पसंद आएगी और आपको सराहनीय लगेगी।
दीपक जी की फिल्म के लिए ग्लोबल एडवर्टाइजर्स ने बहुत सपोर्ट किया है, इस पर आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
हाँ, जिन लोगों ने इनको सपोर्ट किया है उनको हम धन्यवाद देते हैं और इसी तरह उनको सहायता बनी रहे ताकि ऐसी फिल्मों का प्रचार हो, और उनको हमारी तरफ से बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं और अभिनंदन और स्नेह और आदर।
ग्लोबल एडवर्टाइजर फॉर इनोवेटिव आउटडोर सॉल्यूशंस।